Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to the Joe Broadway Road to the Show series here in MLB The Show 17 on the PS4. Now, the last episode, if you missed it, go drop what you're doing, go watch it right now, because it was a very big, historic Joe Broadway episode. He broke the all-time single season home run record, passing Barry Bonds. He now has 74 home runs, but he's not done. The season is not over. There are three more games to be played north of the border in Toronto against the Blue Jays. There you see 74 home runs. Your new king of the home run as far as single season records go, taking that away from Barry Bonds, but he has a chance to add on to that. But most importantly, the Yankees have a chance to overtake the Red Sox for the AL East crown. Now, they're down a game in the standings, so it would be in their best interest here in this series against the Blue Jays to take two of three, if not sweep. Let's see what we can do about that first inning. And this is the bottom of the first now. As you see, Joe went 0 for 1, but he's fielding his position at third base rather routinely right there. Just kind of getting things flowing. Okay, 2-1 Blue Jays in the third inning. And that was a hot shot right at his third base counterpart, but nice stab on the line drive right there. I believe that's Pedro Alvarez. And it remains a 2-1 ball game in favor of the Blue Jays. Now, a little bit of problem right there, a bobble, but you see him stick with it and still make the throw over to first in time to get the out and avoid an error. All right, back to the plate. You got two runners in scoring position, chance to take the lead, but instead this ball is going to be caught in shallow right field. He is out and the inning is over. Blue Jays remain in the lead. All right, so we're 0-for-3 at this point for Joe. The pressure is off, breaking that record. He can just go up there and do his thing, but they are down right now, and well, maybe not swinging at the first pitch would be a better strategy in this game. He's just too eager to jump on every first pitch he sees, and it's been a bit of a problem. They're down 5-3 right here, another routine one. He will not bobble that one, and he will throw on over and get the out. Now, can they get the win? Can they get the come-from-behind win? Ninth inning, and well, he finally gets a hit. This one past a diving third baseman and into left field. So he's got that single, but the team needs a rally. What can the hitters behind Joe Broadway in the lineup do? That's what we're going to find out right now after this replay. As you see, able to just sneak it behind the glove of the third baseman there, diving attempt, but does not come up with it. So here's a ball put in play up the middle, base hit. Now you got two runners on. So you got two on, three-run homer, put them in the lead exactly where they need to be right now. Can they come through with it? Nobody out. Oh, that's down the first baseline and fair. Broadway around third. He will score with ease as this ball thrown into the cutoff man. It's now 5-4 and the rally is on. Just need one more to play some extra baseball. Will they get it? Let's find out. No. They strand that runner at third base and the Blue Jays win. Very disappointing game right there for the Yankees. That might just about do it. We have to see what the Red Sox did. And you see what Joe Broadway did on the day, just the one hit that came late in the ninth inning. Well, it turns out that the Red Sox lost as well, so we're still just one game behind in the standings with two to play. All right, let's win those final two, put the pressure on the Red Sox to win their games, that is, and see where the chips fall. Now, remember, we're still a wild card team to fall back on. We've made the playoffs. We've secured that. We just don't know if we'll go in as AL East champs or as the first wild card. Now there's a base hit up the middle. Runner coming around third to score, and it's an RBI for Joe. All right, starting the day off a little bit better this time around. His first at bat is a successful one, putting the Yankees on the board. They're up 1-0 when he comes back to the plate, and you got a runner at first base, and he hits this one pretty well. It's going to find the gap, and it's down for a hit. Runner kind of waiting to see if that'd be caught, but he is going to hustle over to third base, which is a good thing because Joe wanted two on the play, so he follows up his single with a double, and he's locked in right now in this game, trying to get the Yankees a victory. You see another look at this, and, you know, wasn't hit particularly hard, but he found the gap, and that runner, once he finds out that is going to hit the turf, hustles on over to third base. So, 2-for-2. Like I said, a single, a double, an RBI. Let's see what his third at-bat brings for the day. He steps on in here in a 1-0 game, and oh man, did he get that. Crushed to left, throws that bat away. He knows it's gone. It's another Broadway bomb, and it's another addition to the record total. Now sitting at 75 home runs for the season. Let's hear what the audio is like on this from the game.
A solo shot here to left, number 75 on this great season. And this is now a 2-0 lead for the Yankees.
Okay, so I had wondered aloud in the last episode on how they'd handle that audio-wise if he continued to add on to his record. I actually was more wondering how they would handle it if he were to come back and break his own record next year, if that would adjust to the new record or if they'd still say you're chasing 73. I didn't know. By the way, he crushed this ball as you see the show track numbers, and it goes 442 feet. My goodness, what a blast. But at least they acknowledge that he's at 75 now and that the season continues to be an amazing one for him. There was no specific audio saying he added to his record total. They didn't exactly say that, but still acknowledging the fact that what he's doing, so that's good that is in game. Here he's going to ground out to short. So they finally do get him out. By the way, he's only a triple short of the cycle, and he's going to get another chance at it here. 3-for-4. If he could triple here, he will indeed get the cycle. They're more worried about getting the victory, and right now they're on pace for that. Now that's going to be backhanded by the first baseman who steps on the bag, so he will not be hitting for the cycle tonight, and he will not be hitting a second home run. But he hits one to bring his total to 75, and they get the victory. Much needed. We'll have to see what the Red Sox did in their game and where we are. Did we pull it dead even now with one game to play, or are we still trailing by a game? You see the numbers for Joe Broadway. Those first three at bats were really good.
He's going to get a little love coach.
From his hitting coach once again. That's going to come on over and check in after a nice game. We'll just say thanks, coach, and move along with that. But it's always nice to get recognized. Who doesn't want that little pat on the back for their efforts, right? And hoping in Road to the Show, it sounds like there's going to be a lot of additions this year that they will address for MLB The Show 18 coming up soon in their developer vlog streams and all that stuff. But can't wait to see what they're going to add on to what they started here in MLB The Show 17 with some of the clubhouse scenes and all of that. So hopefully it'll be more interactive, more immersive, and more bringing you right back into like what the player is doing to differentiate it from running your franchises. So, love what 2K does with their My Careers for basketball. If we can just get a little bit more of that moving forward in all sports games, but especially here in the show. So the final game, the Red Sox did win, so we are one game back still. So the best we can hope for is to win, for the Red Sox to lose, and then we'd have a one-game playoff for the division crown. Again, worst-case scenario is we end up as that wild-card team. Trying to turn two here, a little slow getting it around there. He had to go towards the third-base bag to field that. So they get one, not the double play. And that turns out to be a problem because Toronto pours it on here in the first inning. It's already 5-0. Runners at the corners, and they're going to try to bunt for a hit? Really? Joe is not having that. He's going to throw on over to first and end the inning. But the damage is done. Toronto scores 5 and puts the Yankees in a hole right off the bat if they're going to try to take this division or at least a share of it. Oh, that one's right off the shin of the pitcher. Trying to avoid the tag. Not going to do it. He's tagged out by a very alert first baseman. They're fielding that. Pitcher, I don't know. We don't see those scenes about the pitchers walking it off nearly as much as we have in previous years, so we assume he's okay. And look out, he almost gets pegged again when Broadway's up there. I mean, he's got to feel a little gun-shy there. Keeps coming right back at the mound. This one does go into center field for a base hit, and Broadway, 1-for-3, has that single back in the fifth inning. But what can he do now in the seventh? Down 5-1, runner on first, and oh, he crushes it, but is it fair? Willing it to stay fair, it hits the foul pole. So it is a home run, number 76. He did it, folks. Adds one more to the record total. What a season it has been. I mean, you would have to anticipate that he is the American League MVP. He won a bunch of those MVPs. Wherever he's been, whether National League or American League, this year looks like he'll be taking it home as his Yankees squad will be going to the playoffs, and he has smashed some records here. Well, at least that home run record this year. Now this one, wow, how far would this have gone had it not hit the foul screen? Let's see, this was way back. It didn't really have the distance as far as what they estimated, but man, that hit the facing, or would have hit the facing of that very upper deck. So a ninth inning chance. Oh, looks like the Yankees just don't have enough. Foul is caught by the catcher, and the Blue Jays take 2 out of 3 in the series. So that's it. Doesn't matter what the Red Sox did in their game. They are the AL East champs. We could not catch them. But we will be going in as the first wild card. So, unfortunately now, that means we could have potentially just one game left in the season if we don't win it. Because the wild card is now a one-game winner-take-all move on to the divisional round. And it's going to be against the Detroit Tigers. So it's going to be Tigers-Yankees in the wild card game for the right to move on the divisional series to take on the Kansas City Royals. All right, so there we go. Into the playoffs when we come back with Joe Broadway. This historic season now turns to the postseason. We'll see you next time.